Welcome back to the Believe Bible Study. Today we are still in John chapter 10. Today we're going to be doing John 10:37. A verse says, "Do not believe me unless I do the works of my Father." All right, so we did John 10:26 yesterday, I know. But to understand this verse, we need to go back and read verses 22 through 39. So let's do that now. Verse 22, "Then came the festival of dedication at Jerusalem. It was winter, and Jesus was in the temple courts walking in Solomon's colonnade. The Jews who were there gathered around him, saying, 'How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Messiah, tell us plainly.' Jesus said, 'I did tell you, but you did not believe. The works I do in my Father's name testify about me. But you do not believe because you are not my sheep.'" That was yesterday's verse. "My sheep listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they shall never perish. No one will. No one will snatch them out of my hand." Isn't that awesome? Right there is proof of once saved, always saved. You can't lose your salvation. No matter what you do, you cannot lose your salvation. Verse 29, "My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all. No one can snatch them out of my Father's hands." He reiterated his message of once saved, always saved right there. "I and the Father are one." Again, his Jewish opponents picked up stones to stone him. Believe that. "But Jesus said to them, 'I have shown you many good works from the Father. For which of these do you stone me?'" And that we are not, and they say, "We are not stoning you for any good work," they replied, "but for blasphemy, because you, a mere man, claim to be God." Jesus answered them, Is it not written in your law, 'I have said you are gods'?" This is a reference to Psalm 82:6, which says, I said, "You are gods. You are all sons of the Most High." All right, back to verse 35. If he called them gods, to whom the word of God came and scripture cannot be set aside, what about the one whom the Father set apart as his very own and sent into the world? Why then do you accuse me of blasphemy? Because I said I am God's son? And here's our verse. "Do not believe me unless I do works of my Father. But if I do them, even though you do not believe me, believe the works, that you may know and understand that the Father is in me and I in the Father." Verse 39, again, "They tried to seize him, but he escaped their grasp." These guys, y'all, I'm telling y'all, these guys are such hardheads. They cannot see that Jesus is the Son of God and he is right in front of them. We cannot physically see Jesus today, but we can physically see his works. If you are questioning God's faithfulness, don't. God's faithfulness is unshakable. Now, we can make some stupid mistakes, but God is there to pick up our pieces. If you don't know if you have ever asked God to save you from your sins, today, right now, is the perfect time. It is as simple as this. "Lord, please come into my heart and save me from my sins. In Jesus' name, amen." Super simple, and you are always saved. I mean, seriously, let's go back to those verses. It says, in verse 28, it says, "I give them eternal life and they shall never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand." Isn't that awesome? My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all. No one can snatch them out of my Father's hand. Once saved, always saved. No matter what you do or say, you will always be saved. You can never be unsaved. You may later on want to rededicate your life to the Lord. There's a lot of people that do that. You know, they feel like they've backslidden or not living a good life, a God-pleasing life. So they rededicate their life to the Lord. But that doesn't mean that they were unsaved. That just means that they want to re-up their salvation. They want to re-up their life and make sure that, you know, and just have it publicly known that they are making a change. So, you know, there are people out there that say that you can get, that you can lose your salvation. But right there, we just read it in the Bible that you can't. Once saved, always saved. Once you're in His grasp, you will always be in His grasp. That is amazing. All right, here is my last Bible journal that I did before I started writing my messages for the channel here. This one is also in John. It's John 16:9. It says, about sin, because people do not believe in me. The context of this verse is about when Jesus ascended to heaven. He was telling the disciples, don't grieve, because when I leave, the Holy Spirit will take my place. See, Jesus is just one person and can only be in one place at one time. But when He died on the cross and ascended into heaven, God sent the Holy Spirit down to earth to be everywhere at one time. Isn't that amazing? That is like, that is the third part of the Trinity. You got God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And God the Holy Spirit can be everywhere. He can be right here where I am. He can be around the world. North Pole, South Pole, everywhere, all at the same time, because that's just how awesome God is. So on this one, I didn't really have anything that stuck out to me that I made a big theme out of, so I did another of the fish with Jesus, and then I did a dove there, and this is like a crown of thorns, and then the cross. But anyway, that was the last Bible journaling that I did before I started writing all of my messages for the channel here. But and I still haven't decorated the front of this next Bible journaling cover. But hopefully soon. Something will come to me. I just haven't had the inspiration yet, I guess you want to call it. But anyway, let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for the people that are here watching the channel and studying alongside of me. Lord, I pray that they will, if there's anybody out there that needs you, Lord, that they will ask you into your heart, into their heart, by that simple prayer, Lord. Thank you for once saved, always saved, Lord. I am so thankful that we can't lose our salvation, because, Lord, I know I would have lost mine many, many times, Lord. I'm so thankful for that, Lord. I pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, y'all have a wonderful time, a wonderful day, and I will see you next time. Bye.